Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And today, Google released the Android 10 November security update for the Pixel devices. Now, usually this is out for Essential Phone as well, but the odd thing is it's not available for Pixel or Pixel XL, the first generation. So I don't know if they're no longer supporting it, but it's not in any of the notes, and the over-the-air nor the full download is available. Now, this comes in at about a gig and a half or so, depending on how you're installing this. I actually had to sideload it because it wasn't available yet in the system update, but the full over-the-air and full versions are available directly from Google, so I just sideloaded it. Now, the actual build number on this one is 10QD1A.190821.014.C2. And this particular update brings some improvements for Pixel 2 and newer, and then there's also some security updates as well. So for example, there's improvements for Google Assistant as far as the hot word is concerned, but that only pertains to Pixel 2, Pixel 2 XL, Pixel 3, and Pixel 3 XL. So no Pixel 4 support there. There are some updates for the Pixel 4, but if you're using the hot word to activate the Assistant, well, that should be better now on this particular device or on those particular devices. Now, specifically for the Pixel 3, there are improvements for the bottom speaker audio quality. So it doesn't pertain to any other Pixel devices, including this 4 XL, only the Pixel 3. And then there's additional fixes for some devices that get stuck during boot. So it's a stability improvement for Pixel 3, 3 XL, 3A, and 3A XL. So all of those improvements are pushed onto those devices. Now, as far as the keyboards are concerned, there's additional support for Xbox Bluetooth controller mapping on the Pixel 2, Pixel 2 XL, Pixel 3, 3 XL, 3A, 3A XL, 4, and 4 XL. Every Pixel that's supported with this update gets support for that particular thing. So maybe you're trying to map your controller to it, and this makes sense because it's probably a push for Google's Stadia, which we should see pretty soon if you haven't received one already. So that will allow you to map controllers and use Stadia. Now there's an improvement that's pretty interesting to the Pixel 4 and 4 XL, and that is a smooth display improvement. So it should improve the display. However, I don't know if that means it's going to run at 90 hertz more often or not, but it's super smooth either way. I've had no slowdown since installing it a little while ago. You'll see it's super smooth any way I'm scrolling. It just keeps up and I've had no issues. It's not getting warm or anything like that. So that should be great. And then finally, as far as bug fixes and improvements, there's an improvement to the Pixel 4 and 4 XL camera. Now, what that means specifically, I don't know. On the stage when they announced the Pixel 4 and 4 XL, they talked about taking videos of the moon or photos of the moon. I don't know specifically what this covers, but you'll see it seems to respond pretty quickly. If I switch to camera, take a photo, it's nice and fast. So everything's responding nice and quickly. And I've seen no slowdowns with the camera too much, but this seems to be a little bit faster. And that's it for bug fixes. Now, there is no improvement to the screen as far as the screen face unlock with your eyes closed. I actually tried it before making this video. In fact, if I lock it, unlock it, I have my eyes closed now and it unlocks. So they haven't fixed that yet. That fix will be coming later on. Now, as far as security updates, there are moderate to high security updates, and there's quite a few. So let me just read off the amount of them. There's one for the framework. There's one for LG components. There's three for kernel components, 14 Qualcomm component security updates, and two Qualcomm's closed source components updates. So you've got all of those security updates wrapped into one. Close to 20 updates in total. So quite a few security updates. This is an important update, just like every monthly update is. So that should hopefully improve security with your device, as well as also make it smoother if you've got a Pixel 4 or 4 XL, and then improve those other things for the other devices I mentioned. Now, if you have a phone such as a Samsung or an LG or something like that, it's up to your manufacturer to push out those updates. So they may or may not be out at the time of this video. But that's it for this update. There's not much more. Everything seems nice and fast. I've been getting okay battery life on this phone. I would say that it's not phenomenal, but it's better than it was when I did the review. You'll see I only have 18 minutes of screen on time right now since it was last fully charged. But it says full charge lasts about 2 days. That would be with a lot of idle time. I would say 1 day is pretty normal. But let me know your experience if you have a 4 or 4XL in the comments below, or maybe you have a different device. I'd love to hear what you have to say about that too. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.